Hi everyone, I am Gopika IAS, Assistant Professor, Civil Engineering, Sri Narayana Institute of Technology, Adur, and welcome to the new section of Geotechnical Engineering I. In this section, we are dealing with basic equations in your first module. So, welcome to my section. Thank you for your all supports from up to here. Let's see. So let's see what, first of all, let's see what is the phase diagram. So we first figure nokka. First figure nu parnale namukku oru soil eduthe kanyal ayinathu appo main item oru soil mass consider cheyda rendu portion aanu ullathu solids voids. Ini voids nathu endanu varuna annulladhine base cheyidittana sections baaki parneekkunnu. Adayathu soil solids oru mass consider cheyidal ayinte weight same aayittu nikkum. Change in the water and air varicum. Water plus air on dangle the partially saturated soil arikum. Water matre on the fully saturated soil in the varay. New water inland irikuanangle and a number dry soil mass in the varay. So with the number detail item number class or discuss either tolanane, the just on the refresh yam and it matrane if you are sharing. So let's see what are the basic definitions used in geotechnical engineering. First important one is the water content. It is denoted by W. So water content is also called moisture content. The soil in the moisture content and the variety water content. So it is the ratio of weight of water to the weight of solid solids. It is expressed as water content W is equal to WW by WS, where W greater than or equal to 0. Here WW is the weight of water and WS is the weight of soil solids. Second important definition is degree of saturation, and it is simply denoted with S. So degree of saturation of a soil is defined as the ratio of volume of water to the volume of voids in the soil mass. So nammala phase diagram kanda pole volume of voids plus under volume of soil mass under. So other tamilola ratio ana S is denoted by volume of water divided by volume of voids into 100. So here VW volume of water and VV volume of voids. Next one is void ratio, simply denoted with E, and the void ratio of soil is defined as the ratio of the total volume of voids to the total volume of solids, that is E is equal to VV by VS. Here VV is the volume of voids and VS is the volume of solids, and E will be always greater than. Next one is porosity, and it is denoted as N. So the porosity of soil is defined as the ratio of volume of voids to the total volume of soil. Here it is important that volume of voids divided by volume of soil is void ratio, and volume of voids divided by total volume of soil is porosity. And here porosity is represented in percentage, that is VV by VT into 100. Here VV is the volume of voids and VT is the total volume of soil. Next is air content, and it is denoted as AC, small letter AC. So air content of soil is defined as the ratio of the volume of air to the total volume of soil solids, and it is denoted as AC is equal to VA by VV. Here VA is the volume of air in voids and VV is the volume of voids. Next one is the percentage air voids, and it is denoted by NA. The percentage air void NA is defined as the ratio of volume of air to the total volume of soil mass, that is NA is equal to VA by V into 100. VA is the volume of air and V is the total volume of the soil. Let's see what some important definitions. Bulk unit weight, we know that weight by volume, that is kilonewton per meter cube, and density mass by volume, kilogram per meter cube. Similarly, dry unit weight WS by V and dry density MS by V. Third one is saturated unit weight, that is gamma sat is equal to W sat weight, saturated weight by volume. And for saturated density, saturated mass by volume. Submerged unit weight, it is also denoted by gamma dash, that is gamma sat minus gamma W. And submerged density rho, submerged is equal to rho sat minus rho W. Unit weight of water by volume of water, and unit weight of solids by volume of solids, and specific gravity G is equal to weight of solids by volume of solids into unit weight of the standard fluid, that is here we considering water, that is Ws by Vs into gamma W, that is simply denoted by gamma S by gamma W. So by studying this or discussing these definitions, you can simply solve these two questions. First one is soil sample of volume 1000 cm cube is used to collect soil samples. It was found that sample contained 2 kg of soil with dry unit weight of 1800 kg per meter cube. Now 300 gram water is mixed to the soil, then what will be the water content of the sample? And second one is the soil sample has void ratio of 35% and specific gravity 2.7. Using these two values, calculate porosity, dry density, unit weight of the soil with 75% saturated, and unit weight if the soil is submerged. So in this section, we studied different definitions and some general definitions using unit weight and density. So I hope you understand this section. Thank you so much.